Slavic, Germanic languages. And I know this isn't the best diagram. I was able to basically highlight some of these individual languages so you get the idea of where they're coming from. So on each branch then, so the Romance languages, we have Spanish, Portuguese, French, and others that are difficult to read. But the size of the leaves here then also represent proportionally the size of population speakers in the world. So leaves here are modern languages. You have these historic thousands of years old common languages that no longer exist that gave rise to these different language branches, which then give rise to basically these leaves of languages that are very closely related to each other. So does that make sense?
Yeah.
Awesome.
That's what I was just wanting to make sure I was on that.
Yeah, I'm just jumping the gun. It's okay. All right, so just I wanted to show this one more time. So again, going from these language families to these branches and then to these individual modern languages that we recognize today. So of course, this all tells a story of fusion and movements of people and sharing of culture. If we look at today, and so this is an image, this is hard to read. You go into your text, by the way. If you're looking at your e-text, if you click on any image, it'll pop it up so it's larger. And you can also zoom in on any part of that image in your text. So if you're interested in looking at these patterns a little bit more closely, definitely go and look at your text. So in the world, there's about 20 major language families. The estimated, and this is a difficult estimation,